There's another national security threat that the president may be underestimating, and I want to get your thoughts on this. We're talking about the reach of China, the Chinese telecommunications giant ZTE specifically. Yep. Yeah. Do you believe that the National Defense Authorization Act will leave Americans vulnerable to this threat?
I don't understand. If we know for a fact that no country in the world spies on us more than China does, no country in the world steals intellectual property from us more than China does, and they use their telecommunication companies to do it, installing backdoors into routers, all sorts of things, why we would allow them to remain in business in the United States. That applies to ZTE, that applies even more to Huawei. And so that's why, knowing that, and knowing what my colleagues know about ZTE, I don't understand why they would give in so easily, so quickly, and cave on something that would have put them out of business by denying them access to US semiconductors. I'm still puzzled by it, it makes no sense to me, but we got played again, and this cannot continue to happen.
Well, as you know, in his 2016 campaign, the president promised he was gonna be very tough on China. Is he putting that on hold right now, for example, in what you just discussed with ZTE to make progress on North Korea?
No, I disagree on the determination that he made and that Commerce made on ZTE, but on a broader scale, I don't know of any administration that's confronted China's cheating more than this administration has, to be fair. I disagree on the decision they made about ZTE.
Why do you think he made that decision on ZTE?
Well, I don't know. You'll have to ask the White House what it was based on, because I think it was based on sanctions and sanction violations. And I would agree. If the only issue I had with ZTE was that they allowed North Korea and Iran to evade sanctions, then the penalties they're facing are more than enough, more than anything Obama ever did. On the other hand, I don't view ZTE as simply a sanctions violator. I view them as a company that the Chinese government can use to spy on Americans and steal American intellectual property. I disagree with them on ZTE, but on the broader China issue, no administration, Republican or Democrat, frankly, has been stronger or tougher on the Chinese than this administration, and that's been long overdue. We've allowed them to get away with it for far too long.
Well, that's a good point. The U.S. has been weak in dealing with the Chinese copyright infringement and all of that. Have you raised the issue specifically of ZTE with the president?
I did. We spoke about it maybe 2 months ago. We just have a difference of opinion, which is normal in life and in American politics. He viewed it as one way and kind of focused on it from a sanctions perspective. And he pointed to the fact that, you know, the previous administration did nothing about ZTE sanctions violations, and he did. And he's right about that. And I tried to explain it as it's more than just sanctions. We have a different view on it, and that happens. But that's different from the broader approach to China, which I generally agree with. My only difference there is I wish we would have focused on China first and partnered with Europe to do it, as opposed to being in a fight with Europe and China at the same time. But again, you know, people can disagree on approaches. We all want the same thing, I hope, which is a better and fairer trading system for the United States and for American workers.
That's what we all want, absolutely. Senator Rubio, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks, Wolf.
All right, just